Hey guys, all right, I'm back. We're back. As promised a few months ago, we are doing some horror movies for October. We are doing two movies where we're watching the older version of something and then the newer version of something, I think. I don't know. That could change. But for today, we are watching the original The Fly. 1957. See, I was going to say 6 or 8. I was totally going to be wrong either way. 1957. I think I've said before, Dad's a bit of a horror buff. One of his favorite movies is Halloween. So, I have not seen this version of The Fly. Being a Gen X kid, I grew up with the Jeff Goldblum version, which we're going to watch also, because he hasn't seen that version. He kind of, what would you say? A stickler. We said the same thing before in other movies. You always like what you grew up with. So, I don't think you hate Jeff Goldblum. You just prefer this
one. No, I don't hate Jeff Goldblum. I saw him in other movies before The Fly came. I just never got a chance to watch it.
Okay, so today it's my dad's having me watch, and then next week it'll be I'm having Dad watch The New Fly. So without further ado, because I'm probably talking way too much, let's get this show on the road. All right, after about 20 minutes of audio problems you didn't see because I turned the thing off, we're going to start again.
Hopefully.
1, 2, 3, play.
Start at the beginning.
It is the beginning.
You knocked out the whole fanfare.
We already watched it.
No, we didn't, because it never come on, remember? It was always in a little box.
It was came on, but then we realized we couldn't hear it.
I would like to hear it. If that's possible.
Are you ready now?
Yes.
Wait. Why did it do that? I told it to go back.
I mean, the fanfare is part of the film. Okay, for non-film buffs, this is the 20th Century Fox fanfare with now CinemaScope extension after they created CinemaScope.
Hey, this is editing me here. I just want to say this video has been a disaster to edit. The movie in itself, I don't know if it's the frame rate it was shot in. I don't know what the deal is, but every time I had it synced up, within a couple minutes, it was unsynced to our reaction. So I did my best. I pretty much chopped all the movie up into pieces that we'd be reacting to. And then even still, if that piece was more than about 45 seconds long, it became out of sync. So I apologize for that. Also, it was supposed to be up 2 hours ago, but I had problems with the software. It's been one thing after the other, so anything in this video, take with a grain of salt. I don't know why I had so much trouble editing it compared to the Marvel movies I edited just the other day, but I just want to hop in here and say that before anybody complains about it, the sound being bad or off sync or kilter or whatever. Hopefully the next Fly next week won't be nearly as bad, so on with the movie.
You heard the man.
Now, for non-baby boomers and non-sci-fi horror buffs, it says starring Al Hedison.
What, you think they can't pronounce that?
No.
Oh.
But that is David Hedison.
I don't know who that is.
That's what I'm saying for non-sci-fi horror buffs or baby boomers. David Hedison was the star of the TV series, my mind just went blank. Voice to the Bottom of the Sea.
Oh, okay.
He was the captain of the submarine. Well, this is his first film role.
Okay.
Why he used the name Al, because David's his real name, I don't remember. But as most people probably know, when a lot of people go to Hollywood, they want to change either the first or second name to make it sound more film worthy, I guess, or whatever. But he thought better of it after this.
Gotcha.
Pablo Delambre is the name of the central character.
That sounds French.
The last name. But yeah. Okay, that's our lead actress. And... oh, yeah, that's right.
That blood wasn't on there in the other shot.
Are you sure this is your brother? A long scar on his left leg, wore a wound up. Would you mind, doctor?
They needed a doctor to claim he was dead? Wait, how does he have a leg? I thought he was in the press.
Just his head and one arm.
Oh, okay. I thought his head and his arm was the only part sticking out.
No, that was the only part that could fly.
Okay.
Didn't affect his leg.
Got me confused. I thought he was mostly squished.
No.
Okay.
I'm all right now.
I don't know if there's anything I can do.
You are the police?
Inspector Shiraz, madame. Lane, what's going on? Why do you say you killed Andre? Why?
It's all right, Pascal. Everything's all right now.
Madame, will you tell us what happened?
Not quite.
Yes, monsieur. I killed my husband on the land about half an hour ago in the hydraulic press unit.
You understand the gravity of the crime. You say you killed your husband.
Okay, that's been said like four times. We'll figure that part out.
Well, he has had an official statement.
Oh, yeah, yes.
Why?
I cannot answer that question.
This might be completely different than the...
Just pay attention.
That's what I'm trying to do.
Press the button and it was all over.
You keep spoiling me.
Why did you press it twice?
Oh, it was only once.
The stroke count read two. The machine cannot lie.
Oh, yes. Yes, it was twice. I was wrong. I did it twice.
Why? Perhaps you will wait, madam.
Of course, Inspector.
Don't tell me there's going to be a little mini fly with a tiny head. Human head. Like a split.
You're very attached to both of them, aren't you?
Yes. Inspector, what does all this mean?
No idea. She would tell me nothing except that she killed him. There has to be no motive, no reason, except insanity. You've left you several important questions unanswered.
Perhaps he committed suicide.
If he did, why should you say she killed him? And if it was suicide, why such a clumsy method? And why involve your wife? And she was there. She could
handle
this.
Wrong one.
So don't answer if it's going to spoil the movie, but is she hoping that if it has his head that it'll have his conscience, and that's why she doesn't want to kill it?
I'm not sure. I don't think that's ever explained.
Oh, okay.
Maybe she just figures there's a way to... I mean, it's...
If his brain is there, he can come back somehow?
Yeah, because you can't put his head back on his body.
No, of course not.
I don't know what she's hoping, except she knows that's him and he's thinking like a human.
Right.
You know.
Because he's got his human.
Right.
So I guess if that's all she's got...
If that's all she's got, she'd keep him in a cage.
In a mason jar?
Something. Hell no. Can at least talk to him, right?
She'd go to asylum instead of jail, right?
Mm-hmm.
They find her in town. Not sure if that's any better back then. And he'd be raising his nephew then, I guess.
There's Philippe.
Yes, Philippe.
Can I see Mommy again tomorrow?
Probably don't recognize him either.
Did he just give him wine with water in it or juice?
I'm not sure.
Do flies live a long time?
No,
I don't know. Why?
Because I saw that fly Mommy was looking for here.
Oh.
I didn't know your mother was looking for one.
Oh, yes, she was. It's grown quite a lot. But I recognize her all right.
It's grown?
Mm-hmm.
Mm, this is good.
Leading me to believe it's not going to be house fly size or stay that size.
It's grown. I'm glad to see him. I wanted to ask. How long do flies live?
Oh, I don't know.
He's already been asked.
2 months. The The fly you were looking for was in my study today.
Did you get it?
No.
Will you have it with you? Give it to me. Please give it to me.
I haven't got it here.
No, no.
Yeah?
What is this all about?
You haven't got it or you wouldn't ask.
Yes, I have it. It's locked in my desk. Now tell me what happened.
This is not a confession. Although I killed my husband, I'm not a murderess. I simply carried out his last wish.
Well, you can't do that either, legally, right? Unfortunately.
How'd you pick on somebody your own size?
I'm great, but a pleasant surprise. Hi, Daddy. You don't play with that?
Later, kitty. I'll bet you borrow your mother for a moment. I won't be long, I promise. I'll tell you what. Before you go to bed, I'll play with you.
Where's David?
Promise?
Did she know he was doing experiments, like he's some sort of like scientist on the side or something?
I don't know what his actual job was.
She didn't seem surprised that he had all this equipment down here.
Oh, she knew he was doing something.
Oh, okay.
See, it says made in Japan.
Yeah, that's what I was reading.
Now, this is significant. It's kind of like Transporter in Star Trek. They did that so often, it was almost like getting in a car and driving somewhere. It's like they didn't think a damn thing about it. And I was always leery. I'm like, I don't know if I'd want to do that.
But even cars aren't hurt. There's still car accidents.
Well, that's true.
You're right, though. The teleporter is breaking you up at a cellular level. There's something bound to go wrong. 1% of the time.
This was pre-Star Trek. You could do it a lot more easily or quieter. Now he's going to show her where the plate is. When?
God. One little moment, it no longer existed.
Here's a significant
only
point.
Atoms traveling through space at the speed of light. Then here, a moment later, integrated again into the shape of an ashtray.
Oh, you're joking.
Yeah, right.
Doesn't sound possible, does it? But it is true.
It is impossible. You're playing some joke on me.
Protect television. What happened? A string of electrons, sound and picture impulses, are transmitted through wires of the air. The TV camera is the disintegrator. Your set unscrambles or integrates the electrons back into pictures of sound.
Yes, but this is different.
I wonder if that's where Gene got the idea for transporters. Like,
from
how
this?
Old would he have been in 58? I wonder.
Well, he watched Wagon Train growing up, which is part of what gave him the idea for Star Trek. Here's the kicker. Made in Japan is scrambled. Right? Didn't come out right. So it fucked up already.
Yeah.
Now he's like, shit.
But it doesn't matter, does it?
Yeah.
It does depending on what you're transporting.
I'm afraid it does. I don't know how to put his plate of milk in there with him.
No.
Because
yeah.
Anything could happen between his cells and the plate cells and the milk cells.
Don't say anything. If. But that's what he's trying to perfect, though, is to keep things... Because if you wanted to send bottles of milk,
right.
You need the milk to stay in the glass.
Right.
And not come out with milky glass.
I'm saying nothing.
Okay, yeah.
I already said enough.
Oh no. That's haunting.
He's unscrambled. Somewhere.
Does he never come back? Is it going to be extra bubbly or.
Who knows?
The label's perfect.
Of course.
And it's still cold.
And it'll stay that way. Show you something else.
Oh?
business.
No, Andre, don't.
Gerbil?
It might not
hamster.
Work. I don't know.
It'll be all right.
Andre, please.
Guinea pig, something.
Might be a guinea pig, yeah.
You gotta love how early movies and TV relied so much on lighted effects.
At least they had neon lights back then to give it a little more of a scientific look.
Like the original Frankenstein. Had all the
wasn't
electricity
all
going back and forth between the
like painted or drawn on the film after the fact?
What was?
Like some of the older lightning effects like that. And that blue. Was that a light bulb, or did they paint that on after the fact?
No, they didn't paint that on.
Oh, okay.
That was just lighting. Movies and TV.
You're a strange man, Andre.
She was in Jerry Lewis' original Nutty Professor.
Oh, okay.
She's been in so many comedy films, too. Regular on TV and in TV episodes.
You said you were frightened by progress.
In small roles. Well, not small, but...
Do not disturb.
You won't see him for lunch.
Me.
I see what you mean. His writing gets worse and worse.
Mommy! Mommy!
But he came all the way for lunch.
Coming, Phoebe.
He should have known. And he asked him to come down.
Mm-hmm.
So something is wrong. Or he's...
Something, yeah.
Yeah. He's
now
discovered
now
something.
Now we're getting to the crux of the story.
I had something to show you. I got such a flat. You won't see it. Now you let it go at once. You know how your father just boots for catching insects.
See, it's already happened.
Yeah. That's the kind of that after the little boy had the fly, I forgot about the other half of the transformation that we're going to be able to see him. And that
shortly. He won't let her see.
Oh, he's got his arm in his pocket.
Mm-hmm. But, of course, female curiosity. She's got to see.
Oh, yeah, it's her husband, too.
At some point in time,
but in
he probably didn't figure. Probably didn't figure she could deal with it.
What's the rum for in the milk?
Pain. What do you think for? He can't talk.
We'll find a fly tomorrow, I promise. Just as soon as it's mine, I'll start looking.
That's nothing compared to what she sees in me.
And he says, leave. Go away. The typewriter's legible.
Mm-hmm.
I'm all right now, darling. Don't worry. I'll find that fly.
Okay. Why don't you just push her out the other door?
Make out her.
Are you sure you caught it? Oh, Gwenda, no.
The nationality in her voice.
I told you to find that.
But she can do Swedish real easy. She might be some kind of Scandinavian. I don't know.
You've got to find it. The white one. Only the white one.
A lot of them became English.
Because in his brain, he would fly back towards the house. You'd think, right?
That makes
sense.
Come
in the house on purpose.
That makes sense.
Was that it?
I don't think so.
Don't.
I thought I saw a white dot.
Maybe. I know they don't get him. That ain't gonna work.
She just raised the net higher and maybe it would have flown up into the net. It's like chasing a cat around the room at this point. Was there not a screen on the other side, though?
I don't know.
Did they not have screens in
there? No. Too late. Gotta be quicker than a fly.
Yeah, how'd you not know you have a hole in your window? Especially in a big old house like that.
Yeah. I guess because the curtain
maybe
in front
that's
of
how the other flies were getting in.
Fly don't.
Muscle problems, sir?
Yeah. It's difficult.
Think straight. And you've got to
see Professor Oggy and his the will's already going. They'll do anything to help you. He knows it'll only get worse.
That makes sense. Can't make a head out of nothing. No, exactly the same.
He's smart enough to know that won't work. That's the way he sees it. Longest scream in film history.
Which was only about 8 seconds.
Longer than most.
True. And I felt like there was a little bit of a...
There was a break.
Yeah, and then like...
Very quick.
Redid it again, yeah.
More scream. If he gets to a point where his will is gone and he can't think... Who knows if he could even operate the machine. And she don't know how to do it.
No, that's true.
So.
And when the detective talked to her in the beginning, it sounded like she had rehearsed.
Don't you remember in the beginning her saying something about...
Oh, ashes.
The ashes, yeah.
Yes. Because he just destroyed the transporter. Yeah, the detective said we couldn't decipher the ashes. And
right.
I'm thinking, of course you can't decipher ashes. It's broken.
No use now.
Oh. Help.
Yeah, see how he's writing? Help me.
Contain? What?
Or come.
Don't come.
Near me?
Near me.
Kill.
Oh, fly.
Fly.
Please.
Please. Oh, he's, yeah, he's writing. He's getting a lot of.
I figured that's why he's. Leave. Is that what he's about to say?
I think.
Oh,
love you.
Oh, that's. That actually makes me a little teary. What's up there? Have we ever been in that room? I don't think so.
I think he's taking her to the press.
I thought that was at a factory somewhere.
Well, they're right there.
Oh, I didn't realize.
They live right next to it, yeah.
I didn't realize that, I guess, in the beginning. The camera kept cutting from that scene to that scene to that scene. Oh, yeah, see, he did all the setup. There's no way. She didn't know how to do that.
She made all that up.
Yeah.
That arm don't want to lay down.
The fly wants to survive.
Mm-hmm, of course.
And now we're back where we started, pretty much. I remember seeing the button in the beginning.
After the fact, yeah.
Yeah. The close-up, I mean, of the button.
Flip.
Oh, wait, his arm is out.
Yeah, it flipped out.
Ugh. You know, in today's horror market... They would have showed you all that up close. Oh, no. That's the one thing I don't like. I mean, I'm not a big horror fan anyway, but some of the gratuitous, like, grossness in today's horror movies is just ridiculous.
Well, there's no purpose for it.
No.
It's just there to...
But at least there's categories. If you want to go see somebody's head squished, you can. If you don't, you want to watch something else. I heard that.
Mm-hmm. Drug that out of her.
She never saw it.
Leave her alone. She doesn't have to go with that. I demand that I first have time to talk to my attorney. Now,
leave it. I have required doses and also solids.
Already spun a web around.
He's dead.
But you said.
I don't need the evidence for the judge or whatever.
I will take his word.
I saw the thing. It's unbelievable. I shall never forget that scream as long as I live.
Search for the truth is the most important work in the whole world and the most dangerous.
I like that. I like to be an explorer writer. Will you help me, Uncle Francois?
Yes. You better
sequel. About 10 years later, after the kid grows up.
Okay.
So what'd you think?
It wasn't bad.
At least they kept you in suspense.
Yes.
All the way to the end.
Yes, that's true.
Not knowing what was going to happen. I don't know how Jeff's ended. How he killed himself or whatever. But if he did...
You did kind of mention it after the scream. But that's documented as the longest?
As the longest scream, yes.
And what was the other thing you said about another scream?
Faye Ray's in the original King Kong.
Oh, okay.
Is the greatest scream.
Gotcha. So, it's definitely... I can't really say much without giving... Without giving away what's in the other fly. All right. As far as an older sci-fi 50s, you know, horror, it's not bad. Definitely better than I thought it would be.
Well, Vincent never did anything real bad. Well, I mean, he did a couple of really sucky ones later on.
Yeah.
But for the most part, he was always good.
I mean, I guess the effects kind of hold up. He's not as funny looking as I thought he'd
for
be.
For 58?
Yeah.
Oh, you thought it was going to be funnier?
Yeah.
They did a good job
for
a flyhead.
I mean, it
still
did kind of look like a big, yeah, flyhead, rubber flyhead or something, but you got to work with what you got, I suppose.
Right, no CGI.
I don't know. There's not a whole lot to say. I guess
it was
maybe...
more of a psychological thriller, I think.
Yeah. Maybe because it was straight to the point, there's not a whole lot to... elaborate on.
Right.
So.
Pretty straightforward story.
Yeah, that's true.
And they got right to it.
So the second one is not the son of the fly, but rather
Return
he grows
of
up
the fly.
And
Philippe
wants
grows
to do,
up and takes over his dad's
doing more
experiment,
research.
Doing more, trying to perfect it. Yeah, and that's all I'm going to tell you.
I don't think the newer one is called The Son of the Fly, but I for
no,
some
it's called
reason,
Fly 2.
Right, but it does have to do with the son.
I don't know. You've seen the first one. I haven't.
Gotcha. I don't remember either. What the blurb
did
says.
He have a son in him? Did Jeff have a son? I'm assuming. Because it said the main actor in the second one...
Is his son.
Returned
yeah.
from the first one, right?
I don't know. We'll figure that out later. So anyway...
I don't see it making too many variations.
Yeah. Alright, so this outro was short and sweet. That's the original fly. For anybody who lasted this long in the video, thank you. Obviously, I'll put the full length up on Patreon. You have to have your own copy. I'm not sure how to do that with the thing, and I don't even think you're allowed to do that. So anyway, come back next Saturday for...
Reaction to Jeff,
Goldblum's Fly.
And then we'll do the Return of the Fly, 58.
Yeah, that won't be a reaction, I don't think, but we're going to watch that on our own.
Okay.
Just to see, yeah. There's only so many weeks in October.
That's true.
We already got to line up. After Jeff Goldblum's Fly, Dad's not going to be here, so I'm going to react to Dr. Sleep, because The Shining is one of my favorite movies, and I haven't gotten around to watching it, and it'll give me something to watch to keep with the Halloween theme. So until then, I guess, thanks for watching, and we'll see you later. Bye. Say bye, Dad.
Bye.